You almost feel bad trying to ask for a discount on a Subaru because they're just priced out so reasonably. And believe it or not, the markup in most every single Subaru is not all that much. However, there is markup, so pay attention. What is happening, you guys? Ari here with Boston Automotive Consulting. And as always, this video is brought to you by SaveOnMyAuto.com, where you can go on and apply everything that I'm about to tell you in this negotiation guide so that you can land yourself the very, very best deal. And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing because this whole channel is dedicated to giving you all the information you're gonna need so that you can negotiate your best possible deal. Now, what I wanna do is I wanna simplify, maybe even oversimplify this whole Subaru negotiation guide. I'm not gonna tell you the invoice price, 6.5% typically. I'm gonna tell you a target off of the MSRP that I want you to go for. That's likely to happen. Obviously, you're not gonna go greater than invoice price on an Ascent, but on a Forester, you shouldn't be settling at invoice. You shouldn't even be settling at even a little bit of a touch under invoice. You wanna shoot and you wanna get a really, really strong deal on their mainstream higher supply vehicles. So I'm gonna break it all down for you. Diving right in, you guys. Before I list off all of the pricing, etc., I want you to keep in mind all these prices, they're before tax, dealer, documentation fee, registry, all that stuff. Once you see the lease payments, it's not including tax, and it's assuming 10,000 miles a year, and it's assuming that you put all your inception fees due at start. So your acquisition fee, doc fee, registration, first payment, all that good stuff due up front. Now, I've picked out the premium model for most of the trims, and you're gonna see the MSRP as well so that you have a sense for exactly what I'm talking about. As far as discounts off of MSRP, right next to the model, you're gonna see 8%, 9.5%, 5%. This largely has to do with how much wiggle room there is that I'm seeing. A sense they're going for right around invoice, right a little bit above invoice. Foresters, they're cutting some like crazy deals on, but typically being around the 6.5 to 8% mark is definitely a safe target as far as how aggressive of a deal you actually are getting. Anything below it, it's probably due to the fact that it's a more popular or more demand type of a Subaru. So if you can, try to get as close as possible to the 6.5 to 8% mark. Do better if it's possible, but ultimately right there is where you want to land on all the cars that you're seeing here. The Subaru Impreza is the only vehicle on this list that has some cash coming from the manufacturer to Subaru. It's about $500, and the target selling prices you're about to see reflect the $500 in the Subaru Impreza's price. Some of the other models also have manufacturer to dealer incentives. However, you're gonna find that they're on the models that really there aren't many 2019s left of. Legacies, Outbacks, they have a major chunk of money coming from the manufacturer. Unfortunately, we're coming up on that time of year where there's not really all too many left on the ground, and we're dealing with 2020s, as you saw on that original list of the vehicles that I'm working on now. Promotional APR, this is where Subaru typically shines. You guys, 3.29 at 60 months, 3.49 at 72 months. For most any single Subaru you see, they really do offer a pretty good promotional APR anytime you go. And on the Impreza, we're dealing with a 0.9 at 60. So definitely a safe bet if you're going into the dealership without your own financing. Definitely a safe bet to be financing with Subaru, even if you plan on only financing for a shorter duration, even better, because that would actually qualify you for a lower rate. I definitely do want to caution you though. Most every single car manufacturer, they do go based off of the FICO Auto Score 8 model. And in the next slide, you're gonna see the credit score attached to the tier that they approve you on. So you're gonna see the tiers and the corresponding credit scores. Anything above 700 for Subaru, you're gonna get the best possible rates. Anything below, and expect to see point increases as you go down the list of tiers. It's very, very important that you know your FICO Auto Score 8 when you're negotiating these deals. Instead of having to run your credit at all these places, You can go in the link in the description. You're going to find a link to go and get your FICO Auto Score 8 from all three bureaus. That way you have it available to you if you're asked, how's your credit? At least you can tell them and show them your FICO Auto Score 8 instead of having to rely on them to pull it. Now for some more meat, you guys, the lease payments. It's very, very unusual for me to see a lease payment on a Subaru be anything in the high 300s unless you're dealing with a Limited or you're dealing with an Ascent. So really, if you're dealing with a Subaru that's priced out in the mid to high 20,000s, getting in the 200s, definitely a safe target. If you're dealing with Limiteds or you're dealing with higher priced Subarus, low 300s, and the Ascents, more than likely, you're probably gonna pay anywhere around the $400 mark. So guys, I hope that this Subaru negotiation guide was super, super helpful. Like I said before, take everything that you can from this negotiation guide when you're going on to saveonmyauto.com. Make sure you're getting as many Subaru dealerships involved in the deal as you possibly can. Visit saveonmyauto.com. There's a link for that in the description below. Go in, type in your home and your work zip code, and check off all the local dealers. I say it on all my videos, make a spreadsheet, and go after that best deal as best as you can. If you found this information useful, and you wanna see more of these new car buying and negotiation tip type videos, please consider subscribing. And don't forget to visit saveonmyauto.com, as well as all the available resources down in the description below. Thank you so, so much for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.